like a game of chess. The powerful pieces use pecuniary to protect, while we poor pawns are sent to our deaths. How do they expect us to survive a demise when the NHS is being swept from under our feet? Yet the government tends to forget this very concrete was molded by those who pray for steps in the right direction, but were left confused due to deception. They use shrewd attitudes to slew views and misconstrue the truth. Create fake educational avenues to rule over our so-called fools. Hell, even our schools, systems, nothing but a ruse. The curriculum was designed during crippling times when sinister minds cared more for glistening dimes than cold-stained citizens that deserve to shine. I'm not the type to stay at bay when my kind is compared to that of the plague. I candor to the media slander of propaganda, riddled with anger for knowing the East India trade made roughly 12 million from selling slave labor is working long hours with zero to little pay, like the London living wage. Men and women 20 to 30 years of age afraid to move out because spine ill chills from bills makes one soul squeal. No wonder people feel the need to steal. But that's not the only thing criminal. Deceit-filled organizations take the piss. As soon as you make them a profit, they'll throw you to the side like white supremacists did with black lives during apartheid. What a wonderful nation this is. Less love, more cops. Less trust, more dogs. That fly in the sky due to a 22% influx of homeless lives being lost. But that's something the media keeps hush hush. Plus, guess what? Seeping from our very clutch. I'll give you a few clues. It's an economic must and therapeutic crutch. I'm speaking of the arts of cuss, the greatest never outdated creative the world's been amazed with, were not born famous but nameless. Working class roots, they retained it, never once feeling shameless, but the hierarchy have tainted their legacy by camouflaging their art and passing it off as their own. That's treachery. No respect for we should question why newspapers are written in black and white. Perhaps it's because they whitewash our eyes with the darkness of lies as the truth is buried alive. For far too long, our souls have been vandalized. How can we proceed to prosperity when we're being belittled by blue-blooded bigots of austerity? But the greatest mistake the elite make is thinking we will crumble in the face of adversity. That's why I will stay loyal to my soil to the day I die. Screw living free on my knees, I'll forever stand for the five C's. Color, culture, clan, creed, community. That's a fistful of reasons to fight for equality. I said color, culture, clan, creed, community. That's a fistful of reasons to fight for equality in this ununited kingdom. Thank you. This is entitled She, okay? She. The second we meet, I feel ill and obsolete. She seeks to defeat my every heartbeat, especially when I weep myself to sleep, because she knows the pain pushes her power to increase. She's an evil entity whose sole goal is to enter thee, past parts that hurt relentlessly. She loves to grasp dark cursed memories and speaks to me thee, outlandish language of anguish, endlessly. Her intensity cuts through me like an incision. She has a vicious vision that's erratic and savage. Her havoc is something I can no longer manage. She's a thunderous force born from hell that transforms to a form that performs by storm spells to impel the frail who dwell. When she's lurking, I feel nerves and tense. Overloaded with a sense of manic panic, the breath from my lungs have vanished. She forces me to ridicule my reflection. She is the reason I stay with the ceiling and believe in deceiving feelings. She sparks the start of riots in me, violently. Who is she? Anxiety. Woo!